The Philippine Disaster Management Agency reports dozens of additional deaths due to severe tropical storm Paeng. The death toll now at 150, while 36 more are still missing. The estimated damage to agriculture and infrastructure also ballooned to over 5 billion pesos. Relief operations continue across the Philippines. The Philippine government has also released over 8 million pesos in cash aid to thousands of storm victims. Over in Mindanao, search and retrieval operations end in a landslide-hit village in Maguindanao del Norte. The landslide that hit Sitio Tinabon in the town of Datu Odin Sinsuat buried over 20 people. 23 bodies were retrieved, but 3 children are still missing. The landslide also destroyed over 100 homes. Local officials say they will relocate affected families, but no further details were given. Around 19,000 people in the Bangsamoro region are still in evacuation centers days after Paeng battered the country. BARM's Interior and Local Government Minister Naguib Sinarimbo says these are individuals whose homes were destroyed during the onslaught of the storm. Sinarimbo expects the region's economic growth to take a hit due to Paeng's wrath. In 2021, the Bangsamoro region's economy grew by 7.5%, making it the second fastest growing region in the country.
For now, ang pinaka-serious na kailangan ma-address na kagad is to restore yung roads and bridges.
Okay.
So that, one, we can facilitate yung faster na deployment ng relief goods dun sa mga communities na affected. Oh. Second, this is also kickstart the economy dun sa rehabilitation ng mga major roads and bridges natin. Okay. Kailangan natin yon para bumalik yung sigla ng ekonomiya natin. Third, and which is more strategic, long term, kailangan natin i-address yung perennial flooding in the Ligawasan Park.
More rains in the forecast for Mindanao after severe tropical storm Paeng unleashed floods and landslides in the region. Weather Bureau Pagasa says the low-pressure area that used to be Tropical Cyclone Queenie will dump moderate to at times heavy rains over Caraga, northern Mindanao, Maguindanao, and Lanao del Sur in the next 24 hours. Meanwhile, Metro Manila and the rest of the country could expect cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms. The province of Antique appeals for help as it remains isolated from the rest of Western Visayas. Severe tropical storm Paeng damaged critical bridges connecting the province to neighboring areas. Destroyed roads also making the delivery of relief goods difficult. Governor Rodora Cadiao is worried over their dwindling supply of basic commodities and oxygen for hospitals.
Ngayon, mayroong scarcity ng fuel kasi hindi makadaan ng mga fuel tank. Hindi din makadaan ng mga sasakyan na magdadala ng aming oxygen para sa aming mga hospital. At saka dalawang linggo lang daw ang aming supply according to DTI dito sa Antique, sa mga basic commodities namin.
The storm's damage to the country's farm and fishery sector has now reached at least 2.74 billion pesos. That's according to the Agriculture Department. The agency says more than 74,000 farmers and fisherfolk were affected by the storm. It destroyed over 111,000 metric tons of crops and 82,000 hectares of agricultural areas. Rice was the worst hit crop. But the DA assures Filipinos this will not significantly affect the country's supply of the staple grain.
For the fourth quarter, we have 2.59 million metric tons of rice. So that gives us a 70 days. So we were very sufficient. With a damage of 95,694 metric tons, of course, it will affect the supply. But yeah, as far as the sufficiency is concerned, we are still very sufficient, ma'am.